In North Carolina, we have two native pigweeds, the Palmer and the Redroot. Redroot is typically by far got the widest distribution. It's in most of the state. These pigweeds, as we're well aware of, they tend to gain resistance and be difficult to control. As we look in at this Redroot, you know, one of the identifying features is this nice red color that we see at basically ground level and slightly below. That's the Redroot function that we can look at is to help identify, and that's one way to help identify that. So it's also a very similar structured plant, multi-branched, lots of little laterals, just like the other two pigweeds. You can see that the leaf is fairly wide. It's not very bright at all. In fact, a Redroot pigweed has a leaf that's fairly dull. It may even look a little bit white in the center sometimes, depending on the growth stage. You can see a little bit of white hair right there. Redroots are the only ones in North Carolina that are really hairy. You can feel it. You can feel it as you move your hands up and down the stems and the leaves. You can certainly see it with a hand lens. All right, as we finish up talking about Redroot pigweed, just keep in mind that it's common. It's in most parts of the state. You're very likely going to run across it, and you need to be able to tell the difference between Redroot and particularly Palmer. And we'll see how waterhemp begins to spread across the country, but you might need to know how to tell the difference between Redroot and waterhemp as well before too long.